All of your videos should be premieres, but don't worry, I'm not expecting you to roll out the red carpet. In today's video, we're going to be looking at YouTube's premiere function, why you should be using it and how to set it up. I'm David Proud from Proud Business Productions, and we specialize in helping businesses grow through video. When you have your video ready to post, do you post it straight away? Or do you wait for the best time for your video to get the most traction? It really pays to schedule your videos to release just before when you know most of your viewers will be online. But there is a better way than just scheduling your videos. If you only schedule your videos, your viewers won't know that you have a new video coming up. It will just magically appear in their feed. Whereas if you premiere a video, your viewers get a heads up that you've got new content coming. It will let them know what you're going to cover and when that video is going to be released, which makes them more likely to come back and check out your video. If you batch produce your content, and I'll have a video for this next week, then you can also let your viewers know what to expect from your channel for the next few weeks. Another great benefit to premiering your video is that you also create a watch party. Leading up to the release of your video, there'll be a timer, and when this timer ends, your video will go live. Then you'll have a live chat box where you can chat to anyone that's watching your video all in real time. This is a great way to build up your fan base. So how do you premiere a video? YouTube is just updating to its new upload page, and the Creator Studio is going to be standard by the end of the year. So I'm just going to show you using these new tools. Start by uploading your video, and you want to upload it as unlisted. Whilst the video is uploading, do your usual things like adding your title and your description, tags, playlist, thumbnails. Once your video is uploaded, you want to head over to the Creator Studio and click your videos and find the video that you've just uploaded. Click on it. It's going to take you to the page where you can then add it to your playlists, add cards and end screens, and just finish off setting up your video. Now on this page is where you're going to set it up as a premiere. Up the top, you got visibility. So if you click on here, you can change it to public and then set as premiere. Down below, you can click and schedule for a later date. So I'm going to put it for Saturday next week at, 10 a.m. And then all you need to do is click done and save, and it's good to go. So if you click on the link, now your viewers will be able to see when the video will be premiered, and also they'll be able to set a reminder to tell them when the video is going live. One current drawback is that when you select to premiere a video, it turns off external embedding, meaning that if you upload the video to your website, your viewer will have to click back to YouTube to watch the video. This is easily fixable by waiting until your video goes live, and you want to head over to the advanced settings and make sure allow embedding is ticked. Just make it a habit to do this after the video has gone live. So to wrap up, instead of just scheduling your videos, you want to set them up as premieres. This lets your viewers know what content you have coming up and when they need to come back to see it. On top of this, you can also live chat with your viewers when they're watching your video for the first time, and they can also turn on notifications so they know when that specific video is going to be going live. Let me know in the comments when you think is the best time to post your videos, and make sure you subscribe to catch next week's video about batch producing content.